0-0.
So 0-0, it's Lin Shedong to start.
1-0.
And a good deceptive serve here. Seems to be mostly side spin as it's over lifted back. Shallow spinny shot here from Tomokazu Harimoto. Tomokazu Harimoto fights. He's as polite as can be, but when he wins a point, it's like he's winning a match. Oh, good pressure on the move. Anticipation, quick reaction. And Lin Shedong able to save this. Flatter hit right back to the middle. Ripping backhand from inside. Now it's interesting, it's hard to explain the amount of power that these two can generate, but Lin Shedong, it's just out of this world. We haven't really seen it yet. Again, wise beyond his years, we see players like Timo Boll coming to the table, just sort of feeling out the opponent, testing the waters, dipping their toes in here and there. Lin Shedong doing a bit of the same. Although it feels like both of the players are. With all the young talent, if you will, coming up in the world for Team China and Team Japan, the lifespan isn't quite as long as it is in other nations. Practice partner, sparring partner of Tomokazu Harimoto in the crowd.
3-4.
Good variation in the push game. Wang Chunting in the front row as well. This is a match that table tennis fans want to see. Even the pros will line up and show up to the stadium for this one. Quite frankly, Lin Shedong has taken the world by storm. Tomokazu was the talk of the planet for a good year or two, probably and then some. Ups and downs along the way, but in Chengdu went 2-0 in his matches against Team China.
Ooh. 5-4.
And in Omiyage, a souvenir, a gift on his birthday. Wow. Talk about generosity. Tai Kechi. Sets it up nicely with the serve. Lin Shedong right there for the third ball attack. Again, subtle in the delivery on the serve.
Five, six.
Tomokazu shows up. Type of energy you'd want at a birthday party. Depending on your style, I guess. The pace and the placement deep to the backhand. It's Tomokazu Harimoto to level the playing field. Towel break dead even once again. Tomokazu's been hitting the weight room since his early teenage years. 14 years old after beating Timo Boll, took the trophy, took some pictures, went right to the weight room.
6-6.
Not a lot of time. Rest is important. These two are young.
6-7.
You can hear the speed on that, but a good steady low spin shot there from Tomokazu. Protects him to shut down the attack.
6-7.
There's the rip.
Seven.
Into that middle, but on the forehand side, and Tomokazu can barely even get the racket back to recover this shot, to block it. Down the line as well. Picks his placement on the table. In terms of change, there's been a lot of change in Tomokazu Harimoto's game, but he's been well studied over the years. Lin Shedong only 1 year on the professional circuit.
9-7.
And 2 points in front now, the last 3 points in a row for the birthday boy. Big escape. Tomokazu Harimoto was in a tough position there. You could see him just pulling back to get the racket up. Watch this first block. Just a moment there to guess where it's going to be. Lin Shedong has made that shot down the line a few times already. two into the middle. And it is two game points for Lin Shedong to take the first here. Touch low to the net, loaded with spin. How calm does Lin Shedong look? Just perfect calibration with that closed racket to counter back. There it is, deep corner this time around. Not going for the middle because he saw an opening. Has to play with precision and full confidence on this one, right to the line. If it's just inside the table a little bit more, it comes back with interest. As strong as can be, Lin Shedong creeps it over the forehand. It's Tomokazu with the serves to start game two.
1-0.
A little bit off the top of the net here. Tomokazu continues his streak. Game number one, close. Not enough to shut down the player that barely got shut down last week in the deep rounds.
4-0.
First point for Lin Shedong on the scoreboard here. So I told you I'd give you more detail. Last time they played was middle of 2022.
1-5.
It was Tomokazu Harimoto who won 3-2. Good steady spin to the backhand. Ooh. Shovel serve, but a good receive, patient. It's a clever play here. Lin Shedong looking to shut down Tomokazu as he likes to come in and play the banana flick, meaning that backhand over the table. Simple, no stat needed to change here. 7 of the last 8 for Tomokazu. And surprise down the line, complete control here from a player despite only being 1.5 years older than his opponent. They're so young, we use half years, I like that. He's had a lot more experience internationally.
1-9.
Compact backhand, and Tomokazu leaving no question about what he wants in this game and how he wants to do it. Tough day at work for someone who probably could have called in birthday. Oh, second bounce on the table.
Okay.
Just checks the racket there. That's how well he knows the table. He can hit the ball that close to the bounce without hitting the table. 9 game points, though, for Tomokazu Harimoto. 11-1. What a turnaround after being beaten 11-9. But Dong Qiming in the corner for Tomokazu, speaking the Mandarin.
1-0.
Patient play here, both going at about 70%, spinning and testing. Wiggling the other one around, trying to find their chance to really break open and hit the winner.
An attempted one
here, but solid spin, low to the net. Tomokazu good in the rhythm change, varying up his depths on the table. Nice and deep right at the baseline, getting himself pumped up here after a tough game number two. You can understand Lin Shedong already doubling his score from last game. Short side, Harimoto turns that backhand corner. Really uses the core strength on this one. Watch him twist, waist way below the table. Speaking of way, 13 of the last 16 points. Way dominant, but a head shake out here as Lin Shedong steps in front. Hey, Fang Zhendong on screen. Liu hung next to him, Lee Swin in the background. Reminds me of a Simpsons character. I'm not sure which one.
3-3.
A little bit off the top of the net. Lee Swin, actually, an outstanding sense of humor. Has seen more of the United States, I think, than I have. Three points apiece here. Different story than game number two. A player who came back ready, Lin Shedong.
4-3.
Right at the baseline. Subtle in these changes. The push. Normally, when you get into a touch rally like this, players are trying to play the ball half long or on the shorter side to keep the opponent guessing or off the attack. Very casual long push. It's tough to block so many. Not at that speed. Lin Shedong just pulls out all the speed limit signs here. I'm sorry, officer. I've got to get there quickly. Corner to corner, coast to coast, Lin Shedong passes through like a ghost. What? On top of the bounce again. A bit of momentum here. Lin Shedong with the big counter. Side topspin. And then the quick angle early on as Hatemoto's just backing behind the table.
Five, five.
In terms of this being a round of 32 match, you have to remember, participation is a big indicator to someone's world ranking. Someone's level might be catching up to them just because they haven't had enough events in the last year. Lin Shedong, you could argue, is way underrated. So anyone who has to face Lin Shedong before the final, well, probably isn't thankful for that. Remember, Tomokazu 1-0. He's only won the one time they played. Maybe I should say has won the only time they've played. But here, a very different story. Game number three. It doesn't matter. You could beat someone 11-0. You could outscore them by 30 points, hypothetically, and still lose the match. I think I just did a little math. I'm going to say 31. Whoa, fan rush here in the crowd, a stampede. I don't know if they saw Thong Jendong leaving or something. Oh, seats opened up on the other side. All right. Enjoy the stampede here. Fans will fill the front row.
7-6.
I like it. So Lin Shedong in front by one. Man, I've never seen a stadium with such a preference for sides. I'm looking around trying to see why. Vibrating seats on that side. Free candy. Or maybe the Chinese national team is sitting there.
8-7.
Tomokazu with a little bit of fortune here. Japanese team as well, as you can see. Long serve to get quick into the rally. Barely brushing the net on the way over.
Eight.
The quality of the opening spin shot. Tomokazu has a very suffocating game. He can play the ball way out in front. He's comfortable blocking, gets a lot back on the table, keeps the racket so high, but also has a lot of power of his own when you give him the chance to open. Oh, change of pace here, the soft block, the rhythm breaker, the heartbreaker. Dong Qiming cheering on Tomokazu.
Nine.
Tied right back up, a little bit of frustration there. It's interesting. You almost never hear Tomokazu make any noise out of frustration. A foot stomp, okay. Double foot stomp, yeah. Typically, it's just positive reinforcement for Tomokazu, a little bit of relief, some release of that stress. Release of... It's the combination of the two. 9 points apiece, the last two serve combination in game three with Tomokazu. What an angle here on the receive. Getson over the forehand side, and the birthday boy on a game point to go up 2-1. Depending on where you are in the world, there are a lot of things you can do at 18 years old. Beating Tomokazu Harimoto, be nice.
Left. 9-10.
Oh man, interesting timing here. This might be part of the game as it develops and the crowd gets into it. But when they hear Lin Shedong, they know to cheer Jio, but it happened midpoint. That said, Lin Shedong, out of his opponent's timeout, sets up yet another game point. The fight, the fire within, Harimoto roars. I love the pressure here. Think about it, Tomokazu Harimoto was 2-0 at the World Championships against the veterans of China. It is unbelievable that he can be that threatening from that far behind the table. Withstands the power. Harimoto blocks the first one back, one fishing shot, another one deep, and that's what Lin Shedong can follow it up with, that rip of a backhand. Wong Hao, one of the best backhands for generations, on his feet after that shot. Another game point for Lin Shedong. Net for net and down the line. What a cover here. Quick apology, but fast footwork as well. Tomokazu leveling up here in this rally. Look how much side spin was on that. They both had their net shot. A chop from under the table, long push back, and then right down the line, Harimoto knows he has to take his chances. Third deuce point, fourth towel break, and they're back at the table already. Soft hands, and Harimoto earns himself a game point. Who would have thought after an 11-1 victory where it looked to be completely figured out, Lin Shedong, after a few game points of his own, now trying to defend one. It is so fast. I think about Liang Jingquin, I think about Fan Zhendong. I want to put these three players on radar. Look how low that is. Still keeps topspin on it, but that trajectory, how could you possibly get your racket up in time? Fourth deuce point.
14,
so the top 30. And side spin shovel serve comes back deep, just quick enough, but Lin Shedong almost seems surprised at what came back. Clever play from Tomokazu Harimoto. Game point once again. Oh, top of the net, birthday boy, wow. So it's Tomokazu Harimoto in blue with a 2-1 lead.
0-1.
For me, the biggest thing that he's done is rhythm break. The in and out game, changing up the depths. Misses the contact on this one. It's Lin Shedong in this short game to take the first 2 points here. On the scoreboard here, interesting so far, servers, no one's taken a point on their serve. Tends to be your advantage to serve. I'll be curious to see the stats as they develop.
1-3.
Thank you very much. 36% for Lin Shedong. Just to be clear, That means he would almost prefer doubly to have his opponent serve than him. Like it's just a responsibility or a chore to have the serve on your side. Only 50-50 for Tomokazu. Good pressure, full commitment on the step around. Big point to get his second point on the scoreboard coming into this towel break. Good steady play here, Lin Shedong on top of the bounce. That was an impressive start to the rally. I feel like Tomokazu played it in a tough position. Lin Shedong made it look easy, which was not.
2-6.
Harimoto's gonna find his way into the table where he can to get these wider angles. Just a step behind. Not quite as easy to reach those deep corners of the table or the wide angles.
3-6.
Tight serve. Tomokazu does not want this one to go to game number 5. It's the only choice here for Lin Shedong. Cannot win it in the fourth.
Seven,
interesting.
Three.
Spin comes in. Harimoto looking for the deep corner. He's going to try, though. He's going to try to keep it varied, as he's done quite well. Game 2, the best example. Ooh.
7-4.
Got a little bit off the top of the net there on that push, but he decided to take it incredibly early, right off the bounce. That's wonderful if you can do it. But recognizing right away, and playing it very soft, loosening up that grip to keep it inside the table on the receive.
5-7.
It's a bullet. The backhand, he's got a lot of spin on it too. Even though he misses the shot, it's so exciting to see that level of ambition. Ooh, an emoji. Facial expression you can understand. And a timeout now for Lin Shedong. So a bit of a comeback streak here. Ooh.
6-7.
Could have been a bit of double happiness there. No question about the net. Looked like it might have caught the back edge on the way down. Let's see. Either way, baseline.
7-7.
Gets a bit of fortune back. Tomokazu still returns it. And look at this. I feel like he was down 2-6. Time flies, a lot to look forward to here. The power on both sides, the tactical changes from the more experienced Tomokazu.
8-7.
Again, if these two were to wrestle, they wouldn't even be in the same weight class. Yet somehow Lin Shedong has so much power.
Eight,
the timing,
eight.
The flexibility, but this one, it's the turn. Tied up once again. So 6 out of the last 8 points won by Tomokazu Harimoto, but this
eight,
one here out of reach. Lin Shedong gets in. Over that forehand side of the table. Quick recognition, that's not an easy ball to play. Such flexibility in that wrist.
9-9.
9 points apiece. Take a look one more time. Heavy spin serve, low to the net. Pretty good mix of fans here, but home court advantage for Lin Shedong. And a lukewarm receive. Lin Shedong over the table sets up a game point. Look how little spin there was. That was as floaty as they come. A dead serve. You could nearly read the WTT logo on it. And it is game point. Birthday boy! Game 5 coming up.
0-0.
Well, I forgot it was a work day for these two, obviously, but the crowd for the second session really filling the stadium now.
0-1.
Lin Shidong is going to be looking for the wide forehand where he can. Interesting, backhand to backhand. Many would say Tomokazu Harimoto, one of the best backhands in the world, but I think Lin Shidong, no question about it, the same.
And he calms himself
down, gives about a 75% backhand there, goes for spin, showing that versatility in the speed game.
2-1.
But lunging a little bit, it's Harimoto who baits him into playing the backhand from in front of the elbow that way. Nice shallow shot. No timeouts left. It is just these two in the race. 2-11, must win by two.
1-3.
The arm swings are in. The passion is there. That's never been a question. It's one of the reasons Tomokazu's so great to watch. Being one of the best players in the world doesn't hurt either.
2-3.
Good resilience here as Lin Shidong blasts a bunch of shots early in this rally. And then the net ball, watch it. Good spin from under the table, nice recovery. Little tongue out moment there from Harimoto. Down the line, the rip. He turns and scrapes this one off the back of the table. Really laying into this, but it takes a lot of twist. Man, what a satisfying shot to play. Tough on the other side. A game of very fine margins here as Miyuki Hata watches her teammate from the background getting ready for her match. Big one, they're gonna switch sides of the table now that one player has a score of 5 points. Just to keep things balanced and make sure that no one has too much advantage for being on either side, or disadvantage for that matter.
5-2.
But home court advantage, it's tough to control really. Can't fault the fans for cheering on their favorite player. Perfect positioning here as Harimoto brings it back to the corner. You can see stress settling in a little bit for the birthday boy. Not the first time we've seen that face. And an outright shovel serve. Again, the danger of what's waiting on the other side. It's also a very subtle contact. Harimoto acknowledging, saying, okay, good serve, good serve. Two in a row, this time a little changeup, but the delivery is very similar. And suddenly, Lin Shidong within two. Big serves here. We've seen a lot of drama in deciders today. Excellent play to the wide forehand. Lin Shidong on the ground. I hope he's okay. Fell out of frame for a moment, just testing the ankles. Braces off, shiny marbly teeth, one of the best feelings in the world. Congratulations. Omedetou gozaimasu, Miyuki Hata. Outstanding play. Once again, Tomokazu Harimoto. This is cat and mouse. They're just springing off in patterns against each other. Rip, and then it's punched right back quickly. It's almost like a braid. Just shots and threes. And the full X here from Tomokazu Harimoto in celebration. More and more animated. Practically an anime out here. And it is not over yet. But it is a 4-point lead for the world number three.
4-9.
The vocal cords, they'll still be here while he's young. By Wong Hao's age, we'll see.
9-5.
Needs to be careful. Well, careful's not the right word. Needs to be careful about not getting too careful. Needs to stay focused. Tomokazu, Lin Shidong, with a very uphill climb now.
10,
and a more subtle focus, Chole. A bit of calm right there, I think, from a player who realized he was getting ahead of himself. That's why we saw the more calm Chole. It is 5 match points for a big victory here in the first round. Oh, the top of the net, but it's Tomokazu Harimoto, 11-5. 3-2 has taken down Lin Shedong, and he maintains his perfect undefeated record.